they're both running the same weight. But they don't seem to care about each other, you know what I mean? Like, they know they're in there together. They don't seem to care. Look at the difference in size, though. Look. Well, they're like an inch apart. Yeah, they're like a complete inch in diameter apart. Alright, so they're only both focused on getting out. So, we're gonna put them to introduce them here, out of the cage. Well, bucket in for a little bit and see how they do without our lovely Nyla in the shot. Now this one is an African sideneck turtle, and this one is a red ear slider. This one, even though my wife was not fond of me taking home, just wants to be next to her. Here's Nyla, the ring keeper of all the pets. No, why are you gonna run over your new buddy like that? Alright, Nala, you're getting too close now. She doesn't ever hurt the animals, she actually plays with them. We actually have a second guinea pig that I've never filmed before, because I've already told you in the beginning that I wasn't gonna film the guinea pigs anymore. Just because I don't like them. Honestly, I don't trust them. I have nothing against them. I mean, we'll rescue them, but we won't. I can't. But Nyla actually helps one of the guinea pigs get out of its cage every day. But they don't seem to be actually worried about fighting each other at all. So, we're going to keep them in their own enclosures for a little while until we can get everything fully healthy and set. But then after that, we will try to merge them, and I know that the turtles need, first off, let me say that for turtles, that myth that turtles are slow, that's some shit, that's fake.
And that's actually only for tortoises.
Well, my wife says it's only for tortoises, so I guess I've been fooled only, we're gonna, once I get a proper filter, and I'm actually gonna turn this here, this bucket, into a DIY turtle basking spot instead of paying the $40 for the expense of the basking spot that will hold these turtles' size. And also, I'm gonna have to eventually move them to a bigger tank, but we're not worried about that right now. They're still kind of small. For the African sideneck turtles, it's 2 inches of shell should be 10 gallons of water. And for the red ear sliders, it's 1 inch per shell for 10 gallons of water. So together, eventually, they'll probably have to even be ideal would be 120 gallons, but by the time they get that big, we should have our own home and our own pond. Soon that's where they'll go. But we're going to try the merging section eventually later, and I'll have you guys there for that. And we'll see the process. So if you think about doing the same thing, you'll be able to do it. All right. I'm giving my pet rock a bath. We've got to clean our rock. This right here is a big boulder that I found outside. It's actually going to serve as like a sight barrier between the turtles when we put them together in this tank. So this is going to be part of the process of merging two separate turtles together. You just definitely want to give them something that they can not see to, you know, get away. You know, if they want to just be alone, they can feel at least like they're alone. So that's what that's going to be. And then also we're going to work on right now is, well, it's going to be a separate video, but I'm going to work on it right now, is I'm going to make the above the tank basking area. Now that's what we call a clean rock. Alright guys, so now I'm gonna start prepping the turtles tank to merge the turtles. I've got a rock that's gonna get cleaned up. Well, it's already clean actually. Then we're gonna take him out and put him in the bathtub with no water. We're also gonna take the other turtle and put it into a bathtub too, so they can start already getting to feel each other. I've already introduced them a couple times and still haven't had any fighting. I missed out some video footage on those, but you'll still get some video footage. So we're gonna add the rock, we're gonna add our basking spot that we just made. We're gonna take this light fixture and put it up onto the ceiling so that it can reach the turtles when they go onto the basking spot. We're going to take the marbles and everything that's in the little turtle's cage and put them into this cage. But first things first, we need a water change. And we're also going to add a different filter, a better filter in here. So,
just to tell them about the joke.
We'll see you guys soon. Alright guys, so here I have them. They're still not fighting. There's dirt all over the bottom, tough from that rock. They're in here while I'm siphoning out the tank, getting everything ready. I did notice that, remember I said that my turtle was getting a little pinkish coloration on him? He actually really is, looking at the top of his shell, on his feet, his toes, everything. That's actually called, I'm pretty sure it's blood poisoning, which comes from not having the right filter or lighting or something like that. And usually it's normal for when people give you, pick up pets from other people, you don't really know what's wrong with them. So now I have to go and do a whole bunch of research to figure out how to cure that. Seems like they're getting along. They actually look like buddies now. Alright guys, so this is what I've come up with so far for the turtle cage. Or tank cage. I don't know why I keep calling them cages. The thing left to do here is that I just gotta attach the light to the ceiling for the basking spot. I've glued that. This is the way I ended up taping it, so it looked fine. I actually just took the piece that got broken off and flipped it. And with the bottom piece that kind of start where it starts to curve, that basically makes it go down like stairs, you see. And then I got duct tape and hot glue. That's how that's staying on. I wish it was a little bit longer, so if you decide to make it yourself, I would make it a little bit longer, so just so it goes down into the water more. We've cleaned off our rock, put him in there. We definitely need more marbles or something. I just don't want to get gravel because I heard that the gravels can scuff up the shells. I've added, well, first off, this only had a sponge filter that I took from another tank in quickness. Obviously, that's not doing its job if our turtle is getting sick. So this is a 30-gallon filter that I've gotten. It's the Tetra Whisper. And then all the stuff basically that came with the new turtle, the Red Ear Sliders in here too. That's his light over there. That's his little basking spot. I just put that there just so he knows, like, it should make him feel more comfortable, I hope. And then that's his 10 to 20 gallon Repzilla or Zilla something, Zilla filter. So hopefully that will get a lot more cleaner things going. And I've also drilled two holes at the bottom for leakage, just in case water does end up getting in there. Alright guys, until I put the turtles in here. Alright guys, final setup right before we put the turtles in. So I tried putting the lighting from the ceiling, and the tiles are actually so, like, I don't know if they're glued together, or, I mean, I just don't want to push them too hard and have them, you know, break on me. I drilled some holes, and I tried to put some fishing line through or some string through, and I just couldn't get that happening. So then I found this, which is, this is actually, we bought our rabbit years and years ago. They got a rabbit, and it came in this. So I screwed it to the wall in between the lid so that if I ever do got to change the bulb or anything like that, I can do so. It's a very light cage too, and I don't know, man, I think I actually like this setup better because it's not hanging, I don't have to worry about it ever falling. It's, nobody can touch the hotness of the bulbs, like my cat can't touch it because it's in the cage. I know she gets up there on Reptar's cage and she touches those bulbs and it almost kills her, man. She hates it. I'm gonna wipe down this from, because some of the drywall fell on there. But other than that, I mean, we're good to go. I fed the wires through one of the holes so I can easily turn each light on and off. Yeah, the only thing missing right now is the turtles, and I'm gonna put the smaller one in first. I'm just waiting on the temperature to, like, right now it's at 82, so I think we'll be alright, actually. So give me a second, I'm gonna go get the smaller one and we'll introduce him to his big cage. Alright, so here's our baby Red Ear Slider. He's a hisser. They were just inside the bathtub together, and they were hugged up on each other. Like, literally hugged up on each other. But we're gonna put them on the ramp first, right away. And see how he takes it. What's he gonna do? You got a new home, buddy. And I don't want to add the bigger turtle in here until that turtle is inside the water. Come on, buddy. I love the stripings and markings on this turtle. It's very beautiful, even though I know he's not going to stay small forever. Alright, well, I'm going to leave the camera here on him. Well, I go grab. I don't actually don't think that's very much of a good idea. Let's see. Alright, sorry for the hand and the shot. Alright, here's our African sideneck turtle. As I mentioned already in this video, he's got a lot of pinkness on him, which is not good, not a good sign. Let's see, you want to go back? You hear this one hissing at me, the little redneck slider. Alright guys, welcome home. I really wanted that slider to get in the water first so he can find his own spot, but I'm pretty sure they'll be fine. And plus, I'll be watching them all for the rest of the day. Today was turtle day. Here it goes. Yeah, that's perfect. You see how their claws perfectly go very nicely with that reptile carpet. Alright guys, well there you have it. Two new turtles and a new home. What's going on here?